Hi, I'm Crystal. In this course, you will learn how to programmatically manage the tabs of the titleBarTabs object of the application layout control. The application layout is part of the new extension library of Domino 8.5.3 Upgrade Pack 1. This courselet is produced by Rob Bontaku, XPages instructor at Applegate. The objectives of this courselet. After this mini course, you will be able to manage the tabs of the titleBarTabs object, as adding and removing tabs. You will also be able to programmatically switch between the tabs, and show the content of a view control, or a form with the data of a notes document, by using the dynamic content control. To be able to manage the tabs, you have to understand how to use the onItemClick event of the application layout. The subjects. First, we show you the main features of this mini course in a video. Then we look at how the application has been structured. We will discuss the new dynamic content control and how to switch between the two custom controls we use in this application to display data of an employee. Also, we explain how to use the titleBarTabs object. The titleBarTabs is a part of the new application layout, where you can display tabs or a title. To respond to a user's click on the tab, we show you how to discover it using the onItemClick event of the application layout. In the examples, we show you the specific code we have used in the application. You find the code examples also as a link under the resources section of this courselet. Here you see the application when it is opened. The start page shows the names of employees. To have a look at the details of an employee, the user clicks on a link. I click now on the link of Donald Duck. As you can see, a new tab has been added with the details of Donald. Now you can also switch between the two tabs. I click on the Home tab. Now I will search for Peter Pan. I type his name into the search field and press the Enter button and click on the link. As you can see, another tab has been created. Now I want to close the tab of Donald. I click on the tab and then click on the Close button. The tab has been closed now. Now I like to enter a new employee. I will click on the New button. As you can see, a new tab has been created with an empty document. I enter the ID, first name and last name of Walt Disney. To save the data, I press on the Save button and close the document by pressing the Close button. Here you see an overview of how the application has been structured. The application layout control has been placed on the employee app X page. It has a so-called facet middle, where other controls can be placed. In this application, we have dragged the dynamic content control into it and added two custom controls we have created. The first contains the list of employees and is defined as the default facet. It will be automatically be displayed when the application is started. The second contains the employee form. We programmatically select it when we have to display the data of an employee. As the name dynamic content control already suggests, we can dynamically switch between controls with the aid of it. The content can be any control or container. In the property default facet, we specify the key name of the container that has to be shown by default. On the sheet, you see also the server-side JavaScript code with which a specific custom control can be programmatically selected. The code is pretty simple. First, you create a reference to the dynamic content control using the global get component function with the ID of the control as argument. Unfortunately, you can't use class names of the extension library controls to show the methods of the class. To select a specific control, We use the method show, with its key name as argument. The method can have a second argument. In this argument we can specify an action, for example the note ID of a notes document we want to load. This will be illustrated in the examples. The application outline control has several places defined where you can use controls to customize the application layout. One of the places is the titleBarTabs place. This place is used for a description, and one or more links, or containers for links. The links will be displayed as tabs in the bar. We will first show you how to define a static tab. We also explain which properties of the tab we use in our application. Here we demonstrate how you can define a static tab. I first select the application layout control in the outline view and click on the properties view. Next, I select the title bar in the properties. Now you have to click on the Add Item button. I choose for the basic node. The primary reason is that it has a property called submit value. When the user clicks on a tab, then this value is added to the context object. In the onItemClick event of the application layout control, we can retrieve this value and take the necessary steps to select the tab and show the corresponding custom control. I enter the value, page 1. Another property we use is the label property, which displays text in the tab. I enter the text home. Also, the property selected is important. When set to true, the tab will be highlighted. I set it to true. Here you see the code we use to programmatically add a tab. It is used in the list of employees to show the detail of an employee. The first step is create a reference to the titleBarTabs object. The application layout has a property configuration, you need to retrieve it. From the configuration object we can create a reference to the titleBarTabs object. Next, a new tab object has to be created. We use the complexly3Node class, because this class has a property submit value, we need in the onItemClick event. When we have set all necessary properties, we can add it to the titleBarTabs object, and it will be shown to the user. Keep in mind that before you set the selected attribute to true, you first deselect all other tabs. The next sheet shows how you can iterate through a titleBarTabs object. Here you see the code to deselect all tabs. To deselect the tab we make use of the setSelected method, with false as argument. In general, to discover the method of a property, you use the name of the property as mentioned in the allProperties view, and use get, or set as prefix. The code can also be found under the resources section of the courselet. When the user selects another tab, we should be notified to take action. This can be detected when we implement the onItemClick event of the application layout. This event is triggered when you use the complexly3Node class, where you can define a value for the submit value property. Here you see an example of the base code to retrieve the value. All code can be found under the resources section of the courselet. When you save the X page, you get an error. The reason is that an XE event handler tag is created, instead of XP event handler tag. You have to correct it manually in the source code, as demonstrated in the next video. know the basics of adding tabs and selecting custom controls, it is time to look how we can display the data of an employee when the user clicks on a link in the employees list. Also, we show how to remove an active tab. This will be explained in the next two examples. When the list with employees is displayed and the user clicks on one of the links, we want to show the form, however, with the data of the employee. Therefore, we need a reference to the selected view entry in our JavaScript code. This can be achieved by adding the var variable with the value row to the tag, as you can see on the screen. We can access this variable in the onClick event of the column with the links. First, you see how to retrieve the note ID from the notes XSP view object. Next, we have to load the data from the notes document into the notes XSP document. We specify the note ID in the second argument of the dynamic contents method, called show, together with the type of action. This argument is specified as a JavaScript object. In the code, the properties of the object are defined, together with its values. Property and value are separated by a semicolon. In the example, the action, edit document, is specified. However, you can also choose for load document. In both cases, you retrieve the note ID of the document from the var attribute, which is actually a reference to the notes view entry object. When you choose new document, a note ID is of course not relevant. We can also remove tabs. To remove a tab from the titleBarTabs object, you have to use the remove method, as you can see on the screen. The method needs an index, which you can determine by testing whether a tab is selected or not. Thank you for watching this video. You have become familiar with the dynamic content control, the titleBarTabs object, and the application layout controls on onItemClick event. Both controls are part of the 8.5.3 extension library. You have learned how to add and remove tabs. In the examples, you also have learned how to load a notes document and to display its contents on the screen. The techniques are also applicable for the other places of the application layout. The detailed server-side JavaScript code of the application can be found under the resources section of this courselet. We hope you have learned enough to do the exercise.